Hey everyone, I'm Catherine with the Cumberland River Compact.
And I'm Meg with the Root National Campaign at the Cumberland River Compact.
And today we're out here to talk about trees. Tennessee is home to hundreds of different tree species. Trees provide important habitat and food for birds and insects and mammals, and they're also important in the nutrient cycle, water cycle, and carbon cycle. And of course, they're really important to us as well. So we're gonna take a look at some common trees that we see today and how they impact our life. So let's get started. There are so many different types of trees in Tennessee that it can be really difficult to identify a tree that you find. Even professionals have a hard time figuring out exactly what species of tree they're looking at. So don't worry if it takes some time to identify trees. We're going to give you some tips of things to look for.
Here are a few things to look for when identifying a tree. First, look at leaf shape. Simple leaves have one leaflet attached to a twig. Compound leaves have multiple leaflets attached to one stem and then attached to the twig on the tree. And finally, there are needle-like leaves that are long, thin, and shaped like pointy needles. Next, take a look at the tree bark. Some trees have smooth bark, furrowed bark, shaggy bark, scaly bark, or even papery bark. Next, take a look at where the leaves are on the twig. Some leaves are going to be opposite, which means that the leaves are connected to the stem directly opposite of each other. Or they could be alternating, which means that the leaves are offset from each other on a stem. Finally, you can use the overall tree size and its shape to help make an identification. Remember, there is a lot of variation in size and shape, so it's important to have a look at a few other things like the leaves and the bark as well.
If you're out and about and you see a tree that you want to identify, make sure you take a photo of the bark, the leaves, and the overall shape of the tree to help you make an identification. We're going to now look at some common trees that we see around Tennessee.
Out here, we are near a red maple. This is actually an entire row of red maples. You can especially tell that you've got a red maple in the fall. They turn a beautiful shade of red. That's where that name comes from, of course. They also have a simple leaf with an opposite pattern. Fun fact about the red maple, they're one of the most widespread trees that does well from a north to southern latitude. Here we've got another Tennessee native tree, and this is the sweet gum. You can tell it's a sweet gum one way by looking at the shape of the leaves. They've got pretty distinctive star-shaped leaves. And another way you can easily tell you've got a sweet gum is if you look for these awfully spiky seed pods, which can also be more reddish in color. They're pretty cool and distinctive, but just be careful if you're barefoot around a sweet gum. Right here, we've got a lovely native to Tennessee redbud tree. And these are actually pretty easy to identify because they've got heart-shaped leaves. And in the springtime, they've got beautiful flowers that are kind of a light pink purple color.
This right here is a white oak. And there are actually a lot of different oak species in Tennessee, and they can be a little tricky to tell apart. But this oak tree has a really lobed leaf, and it's dark green on the top and a more silvery on the bottom. And you can tell the difference between a white oak and a red oak because a white oak has more curves on the edges. This one is also really cool because on this oak tree, you can actually see its acorn.
We can all understand that on a hot day, it's really nice to get underneath a tree and to feel that shade. But what are some of the other benefits of trees?
Trees improve air quality and human health by removing pollution from the atmosphere. Trees cool our neighborhoods and reduce the urban heat island effect by providing shade. Nashville experiences 25 more days over 90 degrees Fahrenheit than its surrounding rural counties that have more tree cover. Trees can lower temperatures by 1 to 4 degrees Fahrenheit on summer's hottest days.
Trees are actually really important to making sure that we have clean and abundant water. When it rains, a tree's leaves help to slow down the water that's falling on the ground. And then the big roots of a tree help to absorb and naturally infiltrate all of that water. One of the best things that we can actually do to protect our streams and rivers is plant trees.
So are you ready to plant a tree now? The most important thing you need to think about is getting the right tree in the right place. You're gonna wanna look up for overhead power lines, and you're gonna wanna call 811 to see which utility lines might be under that tree. Once you've got the right tree in the right place and you've got it all perfectly planted, make sure that over the summer you're getting enough water to your tree. You're gonna wanna make sure it gets at least 10 gallons of water every week that it doesn't rain in order to ensure that it lives a long, healthy life and it's ready to give you all the benefits that trees provide. Do you live in Nashville? Check out rootnashville.org to see how you can get involved in the campaign.
We had a tremendous time learning about trees with you today. Let's check in to see what we learned. We hope you had fun learning about trees, and we can't wait to see you next time. Bye!